What would the Roman Empire be like if it had survived into the 20th century? Would we be watching Wide World of Gladiators? This episode, Bread and Circuses, is a fascinating example of Gene Roddenberry's parallel worlds theory, which recurred throughout the show's three seasons. Imagine planets and civilizations whose evolution paralleled our own, but with some interesting modifications. Imagine a Nazi-like culture with thermonuclear capability, a frightening premise explored in Patterns of Force. Inspector of the Gun, Kirk and company are transported to a 19th century frontier town where they are mistaken for the enemies of Wyatt Earp. In another episode, a piece of the action, the natives of Iosia fashion themselves after Chicago gangsters of the Roaring Twenties. But for now, let the games begin in Bread and Circuses. Creating the diverse worlds and civilizations encountered by the Enterprise was the ultimate production challenge. We worked on a very tight budget and were forced to recycle various sets, props, and wardrobes, and even actors. So the trick was to give them a totally unique look every time. In Bread and Circuses, we used the same sets that were used in earlier episodes, such as Miri and A Piece of the Action. And since Cecil B. DeMille had shot his epics, Cleopatra and the Crusades, on the same Paramount lot where we shot Star Trek, bits of the wardrobes from these movies found their way into this episode. By Star Trek's second season, the working relationship between the series creator Gene Roddenberry and producer-writer Gene Kuhn was running like a well-tuned engine. Though this episode was co-written by Kuhn and Roddenberry, more often they acted as a clearinghouse for the show's other writers. In lively meetings, their creative sparks ignited as they shaped the writers' story ideas, and later when the outlines came in, they worked together again on the revisions. Then Kuhn, a warp-speed typist, would do major rewrites and pass them on to Roddenberry's office. The result, some of the best Star Treks ever.